Kemptown Carnival is Brighton's largest free community art street festival, attracting more than 30,000 people a year. This year, the annual event looks like it's going from strength to strength. William Ranieri reports.
Good news from the Kemptown Carnival. They will come back this year after its last appearance in 2016. The long rest did well to the free event, now promising to be bigger and better than ever.
We've been waiting so long.
I know. Three years in the making.
It is going to be amazing.
I hope so. Yes, it's looking very, very exciting. We've got a wonderful Trench of Arts Council funding to create five new projects. We're already starting to program in the many stages, around about nine stages and performance areas across the 1 kilometre of East Brighton.
And of course, the carnival is not just the day of the carnival, is it?
No, it is a run-up of many things. I mean, we run a season of fundraising events and activities. This is our launch this evening. And a bit of a celebration, really, because we've got that partnership and support from the Brighton Palace Pier, who are a fantastic partner in terms of the support they're giving us. And really, I think, going to be helping us take things to the next level and making sure that the carnival stays in the calendar for Brighton people.
What do you miss about the carnival, Jeff?
What do I miss? Well, we won't have too long to miss anything because it's back. So it's taken its sabbatical. And with generous Arts Council funding, plus the support of the Brighton Pier, where we are recording this very interview, it's back and back with a vengeance. So I think it's the amazing community involvement. It's the last free open access event in Brighton, and it would not last without the support of generous sponsors like Brighton Palace Pier, and also the Arts Council, and also the fundraising events that are organised by people like Matt Cook, who people will know from Rabbit Events, and he will certainly put his heart and soul into making sure that 20 or 30,000 people have a fantastic time at the end of May.
3 years apart, how did you manage to keep the crew together?
Well, we've actually, Geoffrey Bowden has been the chair of the Kemptown Carnival Association since we founded the Kemptown Carnival Association in 2010, and then we did the first Kemptown Carnival in 2011, and it's grown from there. Geoffrey stepped down after 2016, but the carnival's grown to such a size that that the decision was made to change the structure of the organisation. So it's now the Kemptown Carnival Community Interest Company. We've got local residents on board as directors, and we've got a new working group that are helping get all the planning together, helping to rally all the volunteers around and help out from now and onwards. But what has been the secret? I don't know, pure stubbornness, maybe? To just want to see it live on, I suppose. It's been about 10 years of my life put into it.
One of the key areas that I've helped Matt with is with the fundraising. So we've worked out, you know, I think what I think is really exciting about Kemptown Carnival is the live carnival bands, music, dance, performance, spectacular. So many carnivals around the country now, it's mainly recorded music. But what's amazing about Kemptown Carnival is the live element of it. You know, whether that's through Brazilian-inspired samba or maracatu or other percussion, but actually live jazz, all sorts of live processional music. So I've been honing that in with Matt, working that out as to how that might appeal to funders, and we've been successful thanks to Arts Council England.
But the season of fundraising events, we've got a wonderful night lined up on the 22nd of March at the Concord 2. With the Resonators and Palita Boogaloo, Roots Garden, Barulio, Brighton School of Samba, DJ Eggs Legs. It should be a proper full tropical carnival party. We've got a wonderful children's festival cake bake tea party at St George's Church on the 6th of April, which is free to attend. So plenty of family fun going on there. And we've also got a lovely gig lined up at the Spiegel Tent on the 15th of May with tropical powerhouse Dende and Malakatu, Cruzeiro do Sol, one of the local Brighton samba bands here. And of course, we're going to have the after party right here at the pier. And on the Sunday after the carnival, on June 2nd, we're going to be attempting to do a seafront parade during the day, because we're going to have a lot of visiting samba groups from over the UK and possibly even a few from Barcelona, actually.
What's the event you're looking forward to this year?
I am looking forward to seeing Unified Rhythm out on the streets, because they're very special. Euphoria Steel Pan. There's going to be an amazing great big America 2 element. Again, for me, it's the live processional troops that I like seeing.
If anyone wants to cooperate, volunteer?
Oh, absolutely. They can contact us. They can see all of the volunteering opportunities, performing opportunities, and the community participation volunteer opportunities as well. They can go to kemptowncarnival.com and obviously find us that way, or find us on Facebook, Twitter, all the usual channels. And there are some changes in terms of what we want to do this year. What we're planning to do is open up the parade participation. So people, anybody will be able to come and join in that big morning parade, that parade of flowers.
This is Ranieri for Latest TV News.